Buildings have characters, a certain set of characteristics that define them. And just like that, a typography is always constantly being asked questions of identity and context. When you see a building, you can almost define it with a certain typography. You see a specific architect, and you instantly have a set of typographies that you could relate to that architect. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Show Better. My name is Steven, and in this video, we're going to see 10 typographies that you can use as an architect in your projects. Before we start, I want to thank my Patreons for sponsoring this video. The channel would not be the same without them, so thank you from the bottom of my heart. And I want to thank you for watching this video. So if you could hit the like and subscribe button down below, it would really, really mean a lot. Now, let's start with our video. If we saw Herzog Nimeron's logo, it just makes sense, right? As well as Saha's and Biggs and all the store architects out there. The typography they're using is just a reflection of their architecture. As architects, they have developed a certain trait and characteristics in their work that is so identifiable that we could portray them in a typography. Now, the question is, does your work have a certain type? Does it have a certain character? It is okay if you're still looking for it, many of us are, but you should start questioning your work now with what type would my work be understood best. So I'm going to give you a list of 10 typographies, amongst which we can find serif, sans serif, monospaced, etc. This list is not definitive and or exclusive. Some people may not like any of the typographies that we show here, but they will be able to identify what is definitely not for them and start looking somewhere else. So feel free to add the typography you like the most in the comments, just so we see how everyone differentiates themselves. Roboto is a neo-grotesque sans serif typeface family developed by Google as a system font for its mobile operating system, Android. It was created in 2011 and can be seen on Android phones, YouTube, Google Maps, the LCD countdown clocks of New York City subways, and softwares like Unreal Engine 4. It includes thin, light, regular, medium, bold, and black weights with oblique styles and italics. One tip that typographers recommend is to always skip a weight. So if you're using lightweight and want to make a certain contrast, want to make some words stand out, don't use regular or don't use thin, but instead use bold, and so on and so forth. Meriwether was designed to be a text face that is pleasant to read on screens. It features a very large height, slightly condensed letter forms, a mild diagonal stress, sturdy serifs, and open forms. It was designed by Sorkin Type, and it is a Google free font for everyone to use. This typography is a serif, meaning that it has those little things at the end of each letter, which just make it a little bit more elegant. Like if it was in a suit or something. Rubik is a sans serif typeface designed by Philip Hubert and Sebastian Fischer of Hubert and Fischer. A design studio based in Berlin and New York, the typeface was commissioned by Google for use in a Rubik's Cube exhibition, hence the name Rubik. The design features stout proportions with rounded corners and low stroke contrast. The entire family with 7 weights in matching italics is open source and available also for free on Google Fonts. Garamond is a group of many serif typefaces named for 16th century Parisian engraver Claude Garamond. Garamond style typefaces are popular and particularly often used for book printing and body text. So you can use this for body text. There's no actual way of going wrong with this. It has been used a ton of times and it's very, very good. Besides general characteristics, writers on type have generally praised the even quality of Garamond's type. Like the elegant line and subdued emphasis on show the classic search for silent and transparent form. I mean, like, we can't even describe a building like this. The elegant line and subdued emphasis show the classic search for silent and transparent form. Futura, or Futura, Futura, Futura. I always say Futura, but I'm not sure if it's Futura or Futura or Futura. Futura is a geometric sans serif typeface designed by Paul Renner and released in 1927. 1927, can you guys imagine? It's super old and it still looks like it was released yesterday. It's still being used. It was designed as a contribution on the new Frankfurt project. It is based on geometric shapes, especially the circle, similar in spirit to the Bauhaus design style. I mean, dude, Bauhaus. Similar in style to the Bauhaus design style of the period. So this font is also used extensively in advertisements and logos,
notably by IKEA, Supreme, Party City, Volkswagen, Royal Dutch Shell, Crayola, Swissair, Absolute, HP. I mean, like everyone has used Futura and it looks good and different on everyone. On number five, we have Montserrat. The old posters and designs in the traditional Montserrat neighborhood of Buenos Aires inspired Julieta Ulanovsky to design this typeface and rescue the beauty of urban typography that emerged in the first half of the 20th century. She wanted to design a typeface that rescues the beauty of urban typography from the first half of the 20th century. So the Montserrat typeface draws on rich history of craftsmanship and local knowledge to combine and preserve in a new open source typeface ready to use in the most modern environments. This is the most different one of the bunch, and it's called Space Mono. A Space Mono is an original fixed width type family designed by Colophon Foundry for Google Design. It supports a Latin extended glyph set, enabling typesetting for English and other Western European languages. It was developed for editorial use in headline and display typography. The letter forms infuse a geometric foundation and grotesque details with qualities often found in headline typefaces of the 1960s, many of which have since been co-opted by science fiction films, television, and literature. On number three, we have Poppins. What's Poppin' Poppin'? Poppins is a geometric sans serif typeface published by Indian Type Foundry in 2014. It was released as open source and is available for free on Google Fonts. Indian Type Foundry describes Poppin' as an internationalist take on the geometric sans genre. It supports both Latin and Devanagari languages and is available in 9 weights with matching italics. Bebas Neum. A sans serif font family, Bebas New was developed by a designer, Ryoki Tsunekawa of Dharma Type. Available from Font Fabric, the typeface is described as staying true to the style and grace of Bebas with its familiar clean lines, elegant shapes, a blend of technical straightforwardness and simple warmth, which makes it uniformly proper for web, print, commerce, and art. And finally, we have the master, the king, the dominant one of everyone, which is Helvetica. Helvetica is a widely used sans serif typeface developed in 1957 by Swiss typeface designer Matt Meidinger with input from Edward Hoffman. Helvetica is among the most widely used sans serif typeface, and it just became so popular that it has a ton of variations of the same font. So we have Helvetica Light, Compressed, Rounded, Neo Helvetica, you know, a lot different types of Helvetica. So again, this is a very reduced list, but it can help you if you don't have a polished eye for type, if you don't have a polished eye yet for typography. So also remember to inspect and analyze in your project in order to understand which type suits it best. Kind of like ask your project, like, hey dude, what type do you want to be represented in? And some people still think using serif fonts or using Helvetica can be very generic, but I say that you should try to identify what the character of your building is. I mean, just imagine, the typeface used by Mies van der Rohe would have been very different from Frank Lloyd Wright, or Frank Gehry's would have been very different from Kuhlhaas, etc. They all have a different style, so why not their typography have a different style as well? So if you want to use typographies in presentation boards in a deeper way, I recommend checking out our course on presentation boards, which talks a lot about that, and the link is in the description. Poppins, 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 Helvetica, 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 Bebas New, Bebas, Bebas New, Bebas Neue, Bebas Neue, Futura, 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 Garamond, Garamond, Garamond. Hi, Mr. Garamond, how are you? Great to see you again.